Secret Agent K7 returns.
America's number one adventurer, K7, former United States secret agent who operated in 22 countries, on land, on sea, and in the air, brings you a story of today. We take you to K7's headquarters.
This is K7 speaking. Send in Special Agent B9 for assignment.
At once, K7.
Special Agent B9 reporting for assignment.
Agent B9, I'm going to send you after one of the world's most despicable international crooks. His name is Dimitri Poulos. He makes a business of wholesale murder. Hundreds of refugees come to a nearby island republic to wait their turn to enter this country. Their tourist passports expire. When that happens, Poulos offers to smuggle them into a democracy, usually charging $500 per person. However, instead of risking capture by the immigration authorities, Poulos robs his victims and leaves them to die on desert islands. Here are the records. Stop this man by whatever methods necessary.
Within 24 hours after K7 assigned Agent B9 to the case, a refugee woman was found on a small key off the coast by a fishing boat. B9 and his assistant, Rita Drake, questioned her at immigration headquarters.
Tell us exactly what happened, Pradonsky.
I want to forget. To forget, not to talk.
I know how you feel. But perhaps you can help us to prevent such things from happening to others. You left your homeland some time ago?
Yes. Almost a year ago it was when we landed over. Over there we posted bonds. $300 for each of us. They said our visas would be issued in a few weeks. Oh, it was so good at first. We sat in the sun, Paul and I. It was warm. We thought how good it was to be there and not in a concentration camp.
You talked to other refugees?
No, not at first. We knew nobody. They sat in the sun with us, too. But each day would come new people. Oh, it was good. But still the visas did not come. Too many of us waiting, and we must take our turn. Then it was we began to worry. Our passports were only good for a few weeks more, and when the time was gone, they could not even give us visas. We thought we would have to stay there always.
Was it then that your husband met Dimitri Poulos?
Yes. Yes, it was then. A man told us about him. He said for $500 he would bring us here. He had a ship, and we could come and there'd be no trouble. Paul and I talked it over. $2,000 he had left. Paul carried it in a money belt around his body, so... Oh, I cannot think of it.
Oh, please go on. You're the only one who can tell us what we want to know.
Our money was going fast. It cost so much to live. And we thought it would be better to lose $1,000 than let our passports become no good.
You paid Poulos $1,000?
Yes. We talked one night, Paul and I. The next morning we went and paid the money. That night we were to come down to the harbor. Oh, it seemed so good. We went, and they put us in a little boat. 8 of us there were. And the big boat was way out in the harbor. They said it would be dangerous to bring the big boat in.
I can understand why it was anchored offshore.
And they took us aboard. The boat was so slow. At night we started.
How far out did they take you? Can you tell us that?
No. No, but I remember the stars. They seemed so bright. And then the land went away and there was nothing but water. I remember Paul and I looked ahead. We thought it couldn't be so far here. And then when it got late and dark, they came. First they made us all stand up in a row by the rail. And then they took our money. Paul, he tried to stop them, but they hit him.
Please, what happened then?
There was a little island. So small, but only little bushes. It was near when they pushed us into the water. I was the only one who got there. Oh, no. I can't tell you anymore. It is all I remember. But next morning, it was hot, and there was no water, and then the fisherman came.
I think I know the rest of the story.
Oh, please, Mr. Official. Can I stay here? Will they let me? I can't go back. They can't send me.
Prodansky, I want you to go back there with me.
Oh, no. No, don't ask that.
Now listen to me, Prodansky. Dmitry Poulos, the man who was responsible for your husband's death, will do the same thing to others from your homeland, men and women alike, unless he is trapped.
Oh, no.
No one knows how many deaths he is already responsible for. You're a brave woman. I'm asking you to go back there with Miss Drake. I want you to pose as her mother.
You mean you are going to catch this man?
We're going to try to if you'll help us. You've got to, for the sake of the others.
But they will keep me there.
If you'll help me, I'll try to get you an entry visa so that you can come into this country legally.
You will do that? Then I make up my mind. I help you. I have to. For Paul.
Good. Rita, I have a plan. I've got to get in touch with the Treasury Department. You stay here and take charge of Frau Dansky. We'll start tonight.
That night, Agent B-9, Rita, and Frau Dansky returned to the small island republic which the woman and her husband had left as human cargo a few days before. The next morning, Rita and the older woman went to the waterfront where refugees usually contacted Poulos.
Poulos, he's over there. Oh, I hope he will not recognize me.
He won't, Frau Dansky. You have different clothes. Let me do the talking. Shall we walk over to him?
Yes. Already he has seen us. See? He's coming.
Remember, let me talk to him.
Good morning, senorita. You are looking for someone, no?
You are Captain Poulos?
I am lucky to have so beautiful a girl ask for me. What can I do?
They said back in the park that if we had money, you would take my mother and me. That you had a boat.
So you want to talk business?
Will you take us? We have to go. Our passport...
Yes, they are only good for a week, perhaps 2 weeks more. Is that it?
Yes.
You have $1,000, $500 for each of you?
Yes. See, it is here.
Then Dmitry Poulos will be glad to serve you. Come, we will talk business.
A few minutes later, Rita telephoned B-9 and told him that Poulos had accepted the money. He instructed her to return to his rooms with Frau Dansky. There they waited as the day dragged by.
B-9, it isn't going to work. Look, the sun's going down.
There's still plenty of time, Rita. You weren't supposed to meet Poulos for 3 hours yet.
Maybe he recognized me and will not do what you expect.
I don't think so.
Has the consul delivered the papers?
Yes, I have them in my pocket. This island republic is as anxious to get rid of men like Poulos as we are to take him back to K7. I had no trouble to... Wait, there's a car stopping in front of the hotel.
Where, B-9? Oh, I see it. There's someone getting out.
It's Poulos, Rita. Our trick worked. They're coming in.
You want I should stay here?
Yes, it'll be all right. Rita, you stand over there. He wasn't handcuffed when he got out of the police car. I don't want any trouble. All ready? All right, men. Wait out here. I'll talk to him alone. Come in, Poulos.
Who are you? What do you want of me? Why have I been brought here?
You'll find that out in a minute. Come inside.
It would be better if you do as he says, senor.
I do not know what this is all about.
I'll tell you. Now, Poulos, did you ever see these two women before?
So, that is why you have brought me. I have never seen them.
He lies. He killed my husband. He threw us in the water.
It is a lie.
Take a good look at her. She sailed with you last week, Poulos. Her husband was with her then. There were also 6 others.
And you killed them. You threw them into the sea. You took all their money.
I do not know what this woman is talking about. If this was true, she could prove it.
You know very well she can't prove anything, Poulos. She and the others were met at night and rowed out to your ship. You made a bargain with these two women this morning to take them away again tonight.
It is a lie. I have never seen them before. They cannot
but
prove
it. But they can prove it.
How? How are they going to do it?
Poulos, you're trapped. The money they paid to you this morning was marked. You've been spending it. That's how the police found it.
I do not believe it.
That money was supplied to me by the Treasury Department of the country I work for. It was carefully marked. Through it, I am going to prove you both a smuggler and a murderer. I have the papers here to extradite you. I arrest you on the charge of smuggling.
Then it was a trap.
Perhaps. You've thrown your last refugee into the sea, Poulos. I had to get you somehow.
I'll kill you. I'll kill you for that.
Look out, B9, he has a knife. I could not wait for the law, Poulos. I have shot you. Do you hear? I shot you. And I hope you die as Paul did.
Special Agent B9 reporting, K7. I have just returned. Dmitri Poulos accepted marked money from my assistant, Rita Drake, and agreed to smuggle her and the woman, Frau Dansky, into this country. When he attempted to spend the bills, he was arrested. He died resisting arrest. The three men who worked with him on his boat have confessed. The government has issued a permit to enter the country to Frau Dansky. It is her reward for helping me.
Is a difficult game between smugglers and the law. Because of this fact, those who run human cargo are hardened and heartless criminals. They prey on the world's homeless wanderers, and often the money they steal goes to support some secret cause. Listen for my next story. This is K7 speaking.